Welcome back to the next video on my mini ice cream van, and today is deadline day because tomorrow we're doing a charity hill climb. And well, we've got an awful lot to do, and the stress sort of gets to Sean. He has a bit of a grumble, but I'll give you a little spoiler. We do get it to move for the first time since 1996, maybe. Quick look around at what's going on. Sean has already changed the heat temperature sender down there. We had to have like a little boss thing.
Yeah, that's going to be the only thing that we succeed with today. So,
I've put together this side of the suspension, so this side's nearly ready. Sean just needs to do the... Oh, he's done it already, look. Wow, look, the link pipe's done for the brakes and everything. All the new hoses are fitted. I didn't even know that. Progress, good progress. What else have we done? Drive shaft, clean that out. New boots, new grease. Not fitted yet, obviously. Now on this side. Strip and rebuilt the other hub. Now we're just putting together all the new suspension components and new knuckle joints. You can't really see, the light's bad. But the hub's been built to this as well, so it's all going back together. Sean reckons we'll be going on a test drive tonight, so that'll be exciting, won't it? Maybe we'll go get a pizza together. What we have next is one of them jobs that should have taken 10 minutes, ended up taking us a full hour to do.
Now, Colin, there's the other end of the tube in there.
Oh. That's a good job we're planning to replace that, then.
There we are.
Give it a gentle tap of a hammer and the thermostat housing would not come off. Huh. It's totally corroded onto the studs. Damn it. Thank God for time lapse. This would have been quite a long, boring video, wouldn't it, otherwise? But I had to keep showing this just to show you how long we went working on this stupid, stupid, stupid thermostat.
Welcome back after 15 minutes. I'm still struggling with this horrible thing. And we have actually, I think, praise Odin. I think so, yeah. probably find can't take it out because there's something else in the way, but so the bottom of the radiator is now no longer connected to the car. Or have you got to take the blue and something else out? It's making noises like it wants to come up.
So we did get a little bit sidetracked here. We thought, well, if we get the radiator out, it'll give us better access to the top of the thermostat. We have a new radiator to go in anyway, so why not try and make life easy for ourselves? But like everything else on the Mini, it's hard work.
Trying not to damage a fan. We didn't get a spare one of those. Pushing water around. We need to do a lot of cleaning in there, but yeah. As I can see, lots of very terrible. We really do need to rebuild this car, but that's the next phase. The first phase is just to get it to run. All right, now we're going to stop the tea now.
Bye.
And the maid has turned up to hoover the car. So for nothing else, it's definitely going to be a lot lighter. Right. I'm going to get back to drinking tea. See you later. Not being funny, it's seized in 3 points. Right. And it's probably seized in both. So you're never going to... Just thinking if we chop it up a bit and we can at least ease out each one off of the stud. You should have a car. Colin's Christmas present list is going to be quite extensive of things I think he should have. Chisels are good things. What a chisel.
It's my birthday Saturday. Have a brainwave and think about winding the studs out. Unfortunately, just stripped the nuts off the threads. It was just that bad. while I was away changing the GoPro memory card and battery. We've got all the studs out.
Hey.
All the fuel.
So everything that was on the list for things to try and achieve today so far has not...
Nil poi.
Yeah. Got a little bit of a nick there, but I'm sure we can get away with it.
I don't know how often you see YouTubers filming themselves hoovering out an Indian bay, but something different, eh? So we're just giving the holes where the thermostat went a quick clean with a tap, just to make it nice for when the new ones go in.
Just put the thing really on them threads.
Because you want to stay, don't you?
Yeah, but I don't want to put Loctite on the end, because to be honest, once the stat's on, it'll be all right, won't it? And just double nut them, wind them down tight, put a bit of copper ease on the things.
So they don't get the same issue again.
Yeah. Yeah,
runs on the front. I just assume people have gone along the back. So if we want to be driving this car tomorrow up and down a hill, we should probably have some brakes. So that's what we're getting onto next.
So it basically runs on there. There's a clip there on that front thing there. Way, and we need to give a connection down there, which is a lot easier now the radiator's out of the way. So we can get the thermostat housings now back on. Put a new fan on it. Once we've got the radiator in, we'll put the alternator back on, and it should be all good. But radiator uses metric volts, which we did work out. Colin's got to cut some down, but it doesn't line up because obviously everything's not quite a good fit. So we don't know whether we've got a length on the holes up or down. We'll re-drill it. But we need to get the radiator in to make sure the fan's not going to fail the radiator shroud. Come work on minis, he said. It will be fun, he said. If you have a mate who buys an ice cream van, emigrate, move, disconnect your phone, be somewhere else. That's my advice. We'll stick to motorcycles. At least when they don't go to work, you can throw them in the shed and forget them. Alright. He's gone to find a bike then. It could be sometime. Just really making this up as we go along, you know. I did a whole rant to video about why I don't like minis, and Colin did. Colin likes minis. If your mate ever buys a mini ice cream van, change your phone number, turn your phone off, move or something.
Desperate.
Yeah. Just leave the country. Join the Foreign Legion. If you can still do that sort of thing.
We have the brake lines run. We probably thought, yeah, we need probably need to connect the new fuel line as well. So Sean's just doing the final bits under here, and then we'll be good to go there as well. So now we're bleeding the brakes. We've got a pretty old power bleeder here. It leaks a little bit, but it's still got the job done. Probably a new one for Christmas, I think.
Right, turn it off.
Yeah. Right. So now's the moment of truth. We've never put this car in gear. We've never lifted the clutch. Is it gonna move? In for the first time in almost 30 years, Mr. Popeye has moved under his own steam. Oh man, I'm just so pleased. I think it's only fair for the maiden voyage. Sean gets to do the driving.
Thanks.
Let's see how we get on.
Got my biggest boots in history on.
Oh, this is scary as hell.
The brakes have been bedding in.
We're on the move. That's the guy with the frog-eyed sprite. Don't worry about the bumps a little bit, Sean.
Huh?
Go and stop and say hello. Hi! We got it working! We're going to give it a go for a quick test drive.
Well, it's getting there. It needs a bit of a warm up, we think.
We hope.
We hope, yeah. It's a bit smoky, but
I think the brakes need a bit of bedding in.
It's in a bit. The speed bump, Sean, you slow down for them in old cars.
Not my old cars, you know. What's it?
Gemma's Mini does that. These are actually bigger than they look.
Yeah, all speed bumps are bigger than they look.
Hang on. What?
emergency stops.
No.
There is a break there, but it's pretty pathetic.
They don't tilt backwards at all. They're pretty shocking, aren't they?
Hey, you can see a bit.
Dave's still outside, we're going to play the tunes.
So after a bit of a tune-up, it was my turn to drive, and we thought, well, we'll take it out on the main road. Excellent idea, Colin. So it's starting to get dark, drove out into the road, got about a mile and a half down there, got to a roundabout, halfway around the roundabout, it conks out, and it doesn't start. So we pushed the ice cream van to the side of the road. I live in the middle of nowhere. Eventually a car comes along. Yes, they kind of come and rescue us. Window comes down. Do you do children's parties? The moment we said no, they just drove off. So a bit later on, someone comes along in a 4x4 and they tow us back home. We spend the rest of the night trying to get the engine running. If we was any good at YouTube, we would have taken cameras with us and stuff like that. But hey, we live and learn. So tomorrow is hill climb day. Are we going to make it? Who knows? See you on the next one. Cheers.